Trinity. Thank you for coming along. Thank you for all that he's done for you when he crossed this world. How good God is, how good God is to you, and what God is doing to your life right now. I need somebody just to clap your hands. By way of worship, by way of praise, by way of saying, God, I thank you for life. I thank you for breath. I thank you for breathing. I thank you for the attitude in my limbs. I thank you for a love, man. Thank you, God, for the things that people take for granted. Thank you for the smallest life. Thank you for the we worship you in spirit and in truth. Have your way. Move mightily in us. Limit us the life of you. Let your glory be revealed. Let your power manifest. Let your name be magnified. You said about Elizabeth from the earth, I'll draw all that you've been lifted and I'll draw it. In the name of Jesus, let healing take place today. Miracles, signs, and wonders. The doors of whom believe. Open up cleansing doors. Make ways where there was no way. Open up blind eyes, God. And stop that evil cause of letting the way. Be with me. And we'll go. And we'll give you praise. We'll honor your name. And we'll magnify you. We ask these blessings in Jesus' name. And we'll give you a grand amen. You may not have everything you desire, but the mere fact you're still breathing, the opportunity that you can get what you need, and I get a witness in you. And there are so many great things I believe God has in store for us this season, this year, of our life. We just got to keep it moving. That we can magnify. Somebody says, all the glory belongs to the Lord. All the glory belongs to the Lord. We don't get no credit, no praise, anything. It all belongs to Him. Y'all can worship with us. Hallelujah. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the next We church doesn't make a whole lot of noise. We come to help hold you, mature you, empower you, encourage you, and challenge you to live a better life. Every part of your life, we want you to live better. We want to calm your sense of fear. We don't want you to get up in the morning and say, "Hey, that's my problem." No, we want you to believe and not just exist. Too many people just exist in what they're not living. Jesus, I pray that they might have life and they might have it more abundantly. So God wants you to be happy and enjoy your life.
Thank you.
I'm going to go to the next slide. get a raise up here that is coming to spring. And I think at the end of giving, that took me a favor, and that means I will celebrate in our YouTube family that joins us every Sunday. Come on, celebrate our Facebook family that joins us every Sunday. Those that are on the field of the Sunday. If you have the faith of the congregation, your word promised them that when they get still coming, you would open up the window of heaven and pour them out blessings that they will not have room to receive. And because you are promised people, we take you at your word. It is done in Jesus' name. Speak of God today, amen. It's like going to the bank knowing that you have money. The money don't come out unless you come in and give you that withdrawal. Now, the other hand, so the things I've got, you do it at home. And so I need all the withdrawal. How much of y'all in the pocket? I'm going to get every member $2 million reimbursed deposit in your bank. Everybody with these kids right now, I'm going to withdraw that money. But God has something better than money. God has something better than money because I've never seen money follow a casket. And you can take what you have with you. You have to leave with somebody. So God's going to put a spirit of a pot out there. That means that they walk the way they want. Get what you need from God. I promise you, there's a power down here. And God will just give what you need. And sharing the prayer with me through the course of the week. 9:15 last night. I had to talk about everything else again. I had to go home and get in the book and get more word. And this morning, sitting great people, and see, I got more word. I'm telling somebody. God is the spirit of the power. And he said, whatever you need, that's all it is.
with what will be. Somebody just needed that word right there. Let's go. Thank you.
this was the second missionary journey of the Apostle Paul. Every journey has a mission attached to it. In other words, when you're on a journey, you should have a mission of why you're on this particular journey. What do I want to accomplish on the journey? What do I want to do? How far do I want to go on this journey? But every journey will require you to be put for the journey. Because there are going to be obstacles, there are going to be situations that may come up during the journey. And because we're on a journey called life, we deal with more than we can. And if we're not prepared for life, life will suck the life out of you and call you to exist and belong to you. The pain, the relationship, the finances, the health, the children, the grandchildren, community, the neighborhood, the job. Life can literally take you out of you if you're not prepared for the mission. Every individual on this journey has a mission to fulfill. I'm on this journey to fulfill this mission. So I must be equipped with what I need for the journey. I'm not getting well prepared. I can't go out there any kind of way because I know I'm going to meet some obstacles that can distort me or that can cause me to suffer from my feelings. And then some things can literally turn you around if you're not careful. I've come too far. I've come too far. And he didn't bring me this by the means of it. And so I am a soul of God and what God said about me. Between the situation and the knowledge here that I don't know how it's going to be possible, the good news, you have got to know who you are. What you bring to the table, what is not worth it. If you don't know your worth, nobody else will. They will tell you how they look at you. Ooh, however, there's something greater than what you see. How they use you, that they deny them. And so while he's on this, he's looking at his enemies. He is scheduled to go to a place called Macedonia. For the Lord has ordained you for them to come. Any time that you are going somewhere, that's going to be a good place. That's going to not only be a dangerous, but going to be prosperous. Be ready for him. Be ready for something that comes at you, towards you, and for you. It doesn't matter of where you're going. But when your mind is made up. God doesn't hear it. And when your heart is saying nothing to stop you from going where I need to go, a man of mine that takes somebody's pocket, and you cannot allow distractions to distract you. But you've got to do what the Lord says, keep it moving. In the midst of it, there's no powerful move without a struggle. Okay, y'all don't hear that today. The Bible says these trials come to make you stronger. So there's some stuff I want to go through to get where I want to go. I'm going to deal with some stuff. But because God is with me, I'm going to make sure that what I need to get is what I need to get. Because I trust and I lean on him as a friend of God. So when the storm comes, I've got a problem with the truth and the fear that might turn back. Hallelujah. So he has every tool he needs to get what he's told. And getting there will cost you something. what Paul said about this. If you think that Paul said something, sometimes you've got to get up for a thing to be good at. Sometimes you've got to forfeit people to say, because they're not ready to go where you're going, they don't have the appetite. They don't have the appetite. I want to take you on a trip. it's amazing to me that we will spread bad news quicker than we'll spread good news. But we'll spread bad news quicker just that more on Instagram. You put out bad news. You know what happened to him. You know what happened to us. What happened to spreading good news? So he says, we want to go spread good news. And every time you are out to do good, the Bible says evil is present. It's somewhere else in the Bible. It's because it wants you to sit where you need to sit, and then you become dangerous. Hallelujah. You become spiritually dangerous. You become less than time and not about the glory. Because you're about to manifest some faith that God already promised and put in your life. That's why it's important that God is just like that people. Like minded. How do you get around like minded people? God's ready to go where I'm trying to go, where I'm going to get there. And the thing about it is when you have a destination, you understand that God is with you. There is no chain that can hold you, that can bind you, that can cause you to become captive. Because the Bible still says, whom the Son has made free is free indeed. That means I'm not going back to the old. But if any man be in Christ Jesus, the Bible says he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, means that all things have become new. But you need to understand that you are still becoming new. You have not yet arrived, but you are still becoming new. And so Paul gathered for their own missionary service. So there's a lot of things there. And they understand that they've got God with them. Anytime you move and know you've got God with you, you know it's going to be all right. Hallelujah. And I've got God with me. Greater is He that's in me than He that's in the world. And God is more than He's working the whole world against me. I'm not worried about one or two people causing it. If I'm before you, I'm more than the whole world that can do it against you. That's powerful right there. So know that God says, if I'm before you, I am more with you than the whole world against you. So why are you thinking about the one or two or three people coming against you? When God told you, I've got the whole world that's been coming against you. I've got your back. Well, they understand we have God with us. We have a journey. We're on a missionary journey. We've got somewhere to go. Some men from Macedonia have said, come and help us. But they run into interference. But the interference of the God's purpose, there will always be something that comes to try to interfere with what God has done. What God has planned in your life, whether you want to start your own business, whether your marriage is going, there will always be something that comes to try to stick the 30 years up. Problems and discombobulations in relationships. But I'm here to tell you, when you understand who Paul is, and he's a chain breaker, you will not allow anything to come and disrupt your next move, your next level, where God is taking you, what God is doing in you, what God is doing for you. You will not allow anything or anybody to disrupt the flow of God. You got to sit in a flow of God. You know, first when a runner is running, and they're running in front of y'all, they're not running by nothing on the left, on the right. They got focus time to get to the finish line. I need somebody to understand here. I need to come in the afternoon. You need to be like you in the front of y'all. I got to get where I'm going, and I got to finish the thing outside of this thing, and I'm not going to let nothing stop me from getting to the finish line. I think the power, some of the power of God, which is but there's something that came to try to get in your way. Could it just be a test of your faith? of your tenacity, of your faith, of your belief, to stop your flow. I need to tell you, the devil is a liar. You cannot stop the flow of God when I know what God promised me. And I know what God said about my life. No matter anybody else tell you, that's an overachiever. At some point, without the thought of the future, The truth is that I want to own that. So I want to get a house. I want to build a house. That takes planning, focus, strategy, organization, skills, ability, and then who you covenant with. So you are here, your next level of life is based on your goals and your purpose. When they were on the journey, it was, we got to get the most of them together. We know we're going to run into problems. But the problems were not thought of from day where we need to go. So I need to tell somebody in here, whatever problem you have right now, do not allow it to stop you from getting where you need to be. It's just a roadblock. It's just a stumbling block. It's just a step that you've got to endure. It's not like entrepreneurs got the whole thing going, because sometimes they feel it, because they have a purpose, and they have a purpose and a perception that you can move. They know how to put stuff over here and make that work. So you and I also have such a good word that when we do this, like that was the most important piece that helps change their life or their destiny, but gives them another way to look at the same problem. But we can't do that without knowledge. All the books that I'm reading are talking about the heart of the book. Because the message that goes in the book is only kept the minds of themselves and that they will be at home. Right? And so we have a book called the Bible. Basic instructions before we return. Open the door to heaven. And all we've got to do is get it. Every problem needs to be solved. It's there. All the great things he's done in their life, they become living testimonies of who he is, and they see that. And so they don't make a whole house here. Now, because of the divination, the one word is called all torches, or the poison cellar, so now it's just a mess. And they really don't put people in jail because they come in house here, they don't understand. And if you're not going to be great here, you won't call them rocks. Will not everybody say this? Oh, you got a good idea. Or you're going to do it this way. No, no, no. As long as you know what you plan, what you strategize, what your purpose is for, you're okay with that. Honestly, I know what I'm doing. You have to know that. Don't suffer from a self-identity crisis. Knowing you don't know who you are. I know where I want to go. I know what it takes to get there. I know I'm going to run through a hard life school. I know I'm going to run up against obstacles and situations that I'm strong enough to do. I've had enough experience in life that made me strong. I'm frail, but I've got that courage. I've got enough in me now that I can pull against the church. I've got enough in me now that I can go and let nobody else want to go. I've got enough in me now to go by myself. The hurt is not when you get back to the time. The hurt is when you try it on and people hold it. The people you pray for, the people you sacrifice, the people you love, the people you care for, the people you do different things for. That's where the real hurt comes from. When you turn around and you got the life out. He broke the chains in the prison and he said, you're the one who comes in. That's the good news. So no matter where you are, you got to share the good news. He shared the good news in prison and they ran him upon his family. What can he do? Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Said, you telling me that he went to prison and the people who behold him were converted by his word and said, put him in my house and convert my family. This is the year and the season that God will turn the tide on your back. Even with the people that don't understand you and that's been coming for you. But the enemy meant for your prayer. The Bible says that the Something funny. People have tons of confidence. Thank you. faithful to the end. And you're the Spirit. Everything in your life that needs to be focused will be focused. Jesus, give the Lord everything and have the praise. All over the things of the Lord. We're going to do what we all do, open the doors of the church quickly. And if you're here, you're coming with us and you don't have a home set for looking after us. Hold on. You really need some time to be focused. And you're doing yourself a favor. I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. I don't know what this means. You've got to walk in his way. Deal with Holy Spirit that will automatically empower us. And you've got to let that be part of your life. That will be the beauty of it. That will be your navigation system. That will lead in God. And I'll keep the right thing to support you. God empowers you. He's going to challenge you. He's going to choose you. Bring them to a place of position of Thank you guys so much. Y'all have an amazing Sunday. Enjoy yourself. Go get some food.